So recently, Rae Sremmurd just announced they were headed on tour with none other than Donald Glover, aka Childish Gambino. The tour spans like 13 or so cities across the United States, and my first thought hearing that is, wow, that's a really odd combo. But then I remember two things. Having acts that are in a similar genre but don't make the same type of music means you'll bring in twice the fans and sell twice the tickets. And two, Childish Gambino actually tweeted back in 2015 that Sremmlife was his favorite album of the year. He's since deleted the tweet. So the tour makes complete sense. But now the three respective artists have taken things a step further by casually announcing that they may have a full project together. Swae and Jxmmi have both said in interviews that they view Gambino as an icon, which he totally is. And Swae actually said in an interview with Vibe that, "I got a laptop with about 1,000 bangers on it. I know Childish Gambino got about 2,000, 3,000, who knows. We're gonna come together and make a whole project like Redbone and Black Beatles." I'm waiting on Gambino to say something about it, but if that's true, I'm expecting good things from the album. For one, Donald Glover has proven that he can pretty much do it all. We know he's successful in so many areas, from his show Atlanta to being an actor for a show like Community and creating his own music as Childish Gambino, so I'm not worried about him fitting in with Rae Sremmurd's wild rock star lifestyle. I think a collab album would be highly underrated in hip-hop, and could even be better than Chance and Gambino's collab that we've been waiting on for years. Alright, maybe I spoke too soon. The Chance and Gambino collab still falls under one of the most wanted albums that have been teased. Anyhow, I think the album's possible, but I'm waiting to hear Gambino speak on it before I believe anything is actually going to be released. Maybe we'll get a couple loose tracks at the worst. Aside from the tour and possible album with Gambino, I also wanted to talk about Rae Sremmurd's triple album while I got you guys here. Mike Will Made It announced that Swae Lee and Slim Jxmmi were going to make their next project a triple album. But instead of just making one really long album or three albums of Rae Sremmurd, they decided to make two solo albums and one album together as Rae Sremmurd. So you'll get three albums in one release. You get Swae's album, Swaecation, Jxmmi's album, Jxmtroduction, and them in a third album as Rae Sremmurd that has yet to be named. I think this is a great idea on Rae Sremmurd's part for a couple reasons. For one, the two brothers said they never ever want to go solo or break up the group. But it's obvious as they get more popular that each of them has offers to do things solo, whether it's a feature or a whole album. But with this triple album, they get a chance to do their whole solo album without making it feel as though they broke up as a group. The second reason has to do with the reason the Migos album was 24 tracks long, or that every artist seems to be making albums longer and longer. They want more streams, more plays, more sales. And I don't think this is the only reason Swae and Jxmmi are making a triple album, but it sure doesn't hurt that they're giving you probably over 40 new tracks, and that means more streams and sales for them. But if they were doing it for the sales, at least they made it into a triple album with something new for the fans, instead of just making a 40 track long Rae Sremmurd album. There have been only a few other triple albums in hip-hop, including MF Grimm's Breakfast, Lunch, and Dinner, and Chamillionaire's mixtape Messiah Project, which came in 3 discs. Fun fact, Chamillionaire's mixtape Messiah is the most purchased mixtape in Texas history. I think Rae Sremmurd is really smart to release that much music. The only question is it all good music? That's kind of going to be the make or break for deciding if this triple album is a good idea. If it's good music, they'll have huge success. But if it's bad, then the album will just get filed away with the rest of the Too Many Tracks projects this year. But I want to hear what you guys think. Would you listen to a Rae Sremmurd Childish Gambino collaboration album? And do you think Rae Sremmurd is smart for releasing a triple album, or will it just be too many tracks to be popular? Let us know in the comments, and subscribe to the channel for more videos like this one. You can also find me on Twitter at Thomas K. Welker, and let's talk more about Rae Sremmurd, Childish Gambino, and triple albums.